All right, this is another section on Mainlander's philosophy. This concerns mankind, civilization, and the ideal state. Everybody wants this utopia to come, or waiting for the golden age to come, which is probably not going to come in our lifetime anyway. But like with the whole truth movement, it's we need to avoid this one world government. Not only that, we need to abolish money, and everybody will be free. Everybody learns the earth is flat, and then we're gonna be in peace. This utopia, it's kind of disturbing and funny how people have always dreamed of utopias, and they never come to fruition, of course. But even if it did, you would realize, well, it's impermanent though. You still have to maintain it, and besides that, it defies human nature. It defies nature of man, these utopias. It really flies in the face of our nature. So that's a delusion. Man is selfish. So a utopia? I doubt it. But here's his summary of that concept and where he sees that going. He says, the movement of mankind as a whole isn't any other and can't be any other than the movement of the universe. It's the movement from the overbeing through the being into the nothingness. Every action of a human, the most noble just as the lowest, is egoistic. Because just like the devil can't see his fellow people being happy, the saint can't see them being unhappy or suffering. Therefore, the devil and the saint both act for egoistic reasons and both contribute to the overall movement of mankind. So like a pendulum, he's establishing that this you know, this good and bad relative to humanity itself is which keeps everything going like electricity, I guess. So this movement's final goal is nothingness, of course, but for mankind in special, it is the reaching of the ideal state. The ideal state, like the utopia, as everybody's waiting on. Because even now with the capitalism, there's a lot of guys, especially in my generation, who are, you know, weary of this now. We were just told to, go to college, get a job, et cetera, get a career. And now they find themselves depressed from the whole system and alienated, which even Karl Marx mentioned that. But that's what's going on. They're calling it late stage capitalism. So now everybody's like, this isn't right. So the yearning for an ideal state is there. So the ideal state would be the ultimate utopia, a socialistic paradise to which all efforts of humanity will finally lead. It will be a world without war, hunger, and any sufferings besides the sufferings of birth, age, and death. So he was deep enough too. This is what Buddha talks about too. And this is what the real suffering is. That's why Buddha says birth is suffering. And actually he said birth is evil, because he considers suffering and evil really one and the same. They play off each other. So he's wise enough to say, okay, maybe even if humans got, you know, war, hunger, which really we can't even get hunger out the way because hunger is a part of life. We're always hungry. Everybody's hungry. Like, I think it's funny when people say, oh, we're going to abolish world hunger. Like, well, no, everybody's hungry. That's why you're going to work every day. That comes with this condition. That's what makes it so miserable, is this hunger. But he's wise enough to say, okay, but even if you know, we know what people mean when they say that hunger thing. But even if you did get rid of that with some great economy, you would still have to suffer birth, age, and death. So, but all sicknesses will be cured and people will have lives of joy with just a very small amount of work, because work will almost completely be deported to machines. Like that Jacques Fresco concept, his utopian concept that was in Zeitgeist. So let's take a closer look on the citizens of that ideal state. Are they happy? They would be if they wouldn't suffer from horrible boredom and an everlasting emptiness in their lives now. If they even manage to live such a pointless life until natural death, they will not be willing to force new people into this mess by procreating. So he's saying, even if you get a utopia, guess what? People are going to be bored. And that's what people do now, like, because most people don't seek anything, any deeper knowledge, any fucking way. So when all the work and everything is done, and let's say, you know, you've you satisfied your carnal pleasures for now, then you I'm bored. You know, and that's when the dumb shit happens. That's when people start making those silly ass prank videos and shit, just stupid silliness. Or even worse, they just start fighting each other, finding a reason to fight, argue, you know, attack each other out of boredom and, you know, just a way to distract themselves. But he's saying, but check it, if everything, if there was no more hunger, you know, you were satiated, didn't have to work. I know people who took weeks off of work and said they were ready to go back because they were bored. So that's what he's saying. People don't realize this is what life is. It's striving. It's a deficient state. It's the negative striving toward the zero at best and claiming that that was worthwhile. It's stupidity. So he's saying if we really got the utopia, you would realize how bored you were and how pointless this was, because there would be no point. Because people think there's a higher point to this existence, but it's not. And that's what the Gnostics understand too. There is no higher goal. this is the point. It's the trap. I mean, you're chasing cheese in a mouse trap. So yeah, they will realize that they were living pointless lives. They were just sitting around doing nothing, basically. You know, so he says they would not be willing to force new people into this mess by procreating. Because, you know, ideally, people would see that. They would be bored. And but then you could also argue that they would be so bored that they would procreate to try to, you know, give some meaning to their existence. But anyway, he says, you know, they wouldn't be willing to do that because they would realize that life is pointless. They have no hope left because they know that they already reached the ideal state. Right. Remember, that's what we live off. Hope. Hope, hope. Every generation has a hope, right? Like, you know, it's clear. It's always a hope. Like, what's the hope now? It's like, get the fuck out of here. Like, it's stupid. It's all, when is this shit going to be over? Like, it's me and this girl was talking, like, you know, everybody's about to save the world. Like, the world isn't saved yet. If you're not getting this yet, it's just birth and death. Every new generation comes on stage, deluded as hell, with some hope. And really, none of the problems get solved. People just die off and the problems change. Then there's another hope. But he's saying they don't have any hope anymore, because if everything's satiated, what the fuck are you going to do now? There's no hope. Remember, hope is what people live for. So, therefore, they will come to the conclusion that human life has to end, or maybe even that all life has to end. And that's some of the philosophies coming out, too. They will be considered fringe, but they actually are pretty wise to see the necessity to reverse this existence, this stupid carnage down here, this suffering and carnage. Yeah, ideally, this would be reversed, this creation. So, the conclusion that human life has to end, or maybe even that all life has to end, because they finally realize that there is nothing to accomplish for sentience, and that it would be better if they never had existed. And that's the title of David Benatar's book, Better Never Have Been Born. Because it's the truth. What is the point? Beyond brute rationale, which most men have, there is no point. It's stupid. This will be the point where the movement of humanity, or even the movement of all life on Earth, will be fulfilled, and the universe would now have to move on without human life on Earth to reach its own final goal, which is exactly the same, turning into nothingness. So again, that's his conclusion, that the hidden purpose behind all of this, as he said, was God, or the non-dual, decided to kill itself, become creation so that it could die and become nothing. It's very interesting and sort of also intellectually entertaining to think about it in that way. But that's what he's saying. So even if you get this utopia, you get the Illuminati out, there's no hunger. People don't have to work or survive. They find a way to not do that. Like these transhumanists are talking about. You're going to sit around bored. You're going to realize how pointless this shit was. And you'll realize, well, what if the ultimate goal is nothingness? And it is. For the wise, they say it's nothingness, because there's nothing to be gained here with sentient life. Peace. have to suffer birth, age, and death. So, but all sicknesses will be cured and people will have lives of joy with just a very small amount of work, because work will almost completely be deported to machines. Like that Jacques Fresco concept, his utopian concept that was in Zeitgeist. So let's take a closer look on the citizens of that ideal state. Are they happy? They would be if they wouldn't suffer from horrible boredom and an everlasting emptiness in their lives now. If they even manage to live such a pointless life until natural death, they will not be willing to force new people into this mess by procreating. So he's saying, even if you get a utopia, guess what? People are going to be bored. And that's what people do now, like, because most people don't seek anything, any deeper knowledge, any fucking way. So when all the work and everything is done, and let's say, you know, you satisfied your carnal pleasures for now, then you're, oh, I'm bored. You know, and that's when the dumb shit happens. That's when people start making those silly ass prank videos and shit, just stupid silliness. Or even worse, they just start fighting each other, finding a reason to fight, argue, you know, attack each other out of boredom and, you know, just a way to distract themselves. But he's saying, but check it, if there was no more hunger, you know, you were satiated, didn't have to work. I know people who took weeks off of work and said they were ready to go back because they were bored. So that's what he's saying. People don't realize this is what life is. It's striving. It's a deficient state. It's the negative striving toward the zero at best, and claiming that that was worthwhile is stupidity. So he's saying if we really got the utopia, you will realize how bored you were and how pointless this was, because there will be no point. Because people think there's a higher point to this existence, but it's not. And that's what the Gnostics understand too. There is no higher goal. This is the point. It's the trap. I mean, you're chasing cheese in a mouse trap. So, yeah, they will realize that they were living pointless lives. They were just sitting around doing nothing, basically. You know, so he says they would not be willing to force new people into this mess by procreating. Because, you know, ideally, people would see that. They would be bored. And but then you could also argue that they would be so bored that they would procreate to try to, you know, give some meaning to their existence. But anyway, he says, you know, they wouldn't be willing to do that because they would realize their life is pointless. They have no hope left because they know that they already reached the ideal state. Right. Remember, that's what we live off. Hope. Hope, hope. Every generation has a hope, right? Like, but he's wise enough to say, okay, but even if you, you know, we know what people mean when they say that hunger thing. But even if you did get rid of that with some great economy, you would still have to suffer birth, age, and death. So, but all sicknesses will be cured and people will have lives of joy with just a very small amount of work, because work will almost completely be deported to machines. Like that Jacques Fresco concept, his utopian concept that was in Zeitgeist. So let's take a closer look on the citizens of that ideal state. Are they happy? They would be if they wouldn't suffer from horrible boredom and an everlasting emptiness in their lives now. If they even manage to live such a pointless life until natural death, they will not be willing to force new people into this mess by procreating. So he's saying, even if you get a utopia, guess what? People are going to be bored. And that's what people do now, like, because most people don't seek anything, any deeper knowledge, any fucking way. So when all the work and everything is done, and let's say, you know, you satisfied your carnal pleasures for now, then you're, oh, I'm bored. You know, and that's when the dumb shit happens. That's when people start making those silly ass prank videos and shit, just stupid silliness. Or even worse, they just start fighting each other, finding a reason to fight, argue, you know, attack each other out of boredom and you know, just a way to distract themselves. But he's saying, but check it, if there was no more hunger, you know, you were satiated, didn't have to work. I know people who took weeks off of work and said they were ready to go back because they were bored. So that's what he's saying. People don't realize this is what life is. It's striving. It's a deficient state. It's the negative striving toward the zero at best, and claiming that that was worthwhile is stupidity. So he's saying if we really got the utopia, you will realize how bored you were and how pointless this was, because there will be no point. Because people think there's a higher point to this existence, but it's not. And that's what the Gnostics understand too. There is no higher goal. this is the point. It's the trap. I mean, you're chasing cheese in a mouse trap. So, yeah, they will realize that they were living pointless lives. They were just sitting around doing nothing, basically. You know, so he says they would not be willing to force new people into this mess by procreating. Because, you know, ideally, people would see that. They would be bored. And but then you could also argue that they would be so bored that they would procreate to try to, you know, give some meaning to their existence. But anyway, he says, you know, they wouldn't be willing to do that because they would realize their life is pointless. They have no hope left because they know that they already reached the ideal state. They play off each other. So he's wise enough to say, okay, maybe even if humans got, you know, war, hunger, which really we can't even get hunger out the way because hunger is a part of life. We're always hungry. Everybody's hungry. Like, I think it's funny when people say, oh, we're going to abolish world hunger. Like, well, no, everybody's hungry. That's why you're going to work every day. That comes with this condition. That's what makes it so miserable, is this hunger. But he's wise enough to say, okay, but even if you know, we know what people mean when they say that hunger thing. But even if you did get rid of that with some great economy, you would still have to suffer birth, age, and death. So, but all sicknesses will be cured and people will have lives of joy with just a very small amount of work, because work will almost completely be deported to machines. Like that Jacques Fresco concept, his utopian concept that was in Zeitgeist. So let's take a closer look on the citizens of that ideal state. Are they happy? They would be if they wouldn't suffer from horrible boredom and an everlasting emptiness in their lives now. If they even manage to live such a pointless life until natural death, they will not be willing to force new people into this mess by procreating. So he's saying, even if you get a utopia, guess what? People are going to be bored. And that's what people do now, like, because most people don't seek anything, any deeper knowledge, any fucking way. So when all the work and everything is done, and let's say, you know, you satisfied your carnal pleasures for now, then I'm bored. You know, and that's when the dumb shit happens. That's when people start making those silly ass prank videos and shit, just stupid silliness. Or even worse, they just start fighting each other, finding a reason to fight, argue, you know, attack each other out of boredom and, you know, just a way to distract themselves. But he's saying, but check it, if there was no more hunger, you know, you were satiated, didn't have to work. I know people who took weeks off of work and just said they were ready to go back because they were bored. So that's what he's saying. People don't realize this is what life is. It's striving. It's a deficient state. It's the negative striving toward the zero at best, and claiming that that was worthwhile is stupidity. So he's saying if we really got the utopia, you will realize how bored you were and how pointless this was, because there will be no point. Because people think there's a higher point to this existence, but it's not. And that's what the Gnostics understand too. There is no higher goal. this is the point. It's the trap. I mean, you're chasing cheese in a mouse trap. So, yeah, they would realize that they were living pointless lives. They were just sitting around doing nothing, basically. You know, so he says they would not be willing to force new people into this mess by procreating.